Hey everyone, ocean conservation and marine life expert Jaclyn Friedlander here, and today we are going to talk about the negative effects of plastic on oysters. The results of a study conducted by researchers in Europe were just released, and the findings are quite disturbing. Oysters were divided into two groups, and one group was exposed to microplastics like those found in the ocean, and the control group was raised in uncontaminated water. The group exposed to plastic reproduced 41% less than the control group and had to consume much more microalgae to gather the same amount of energy. Oysters are filter feeders, meaning they take in water, keep the microalgae inside as food, and then put the unneeded water back. Since microplastics are about the size of the head of a pin, they do not get filtered back out with the rest of the water, so ultimately the oysters are eating plastic. In the wild, oysters are exposed to anywhere between 0.8 milligrams and 2,500 milligrams of plastic per liter of water. For this experiment, they were exposed to 0.01 milligrams of plastic per liter, and with just that small amount of plastic, they had growth and reproductive ramifications. The good news is that a bill was signed into law in December that will remove all products with microbeads from American shelves by July of 2017. In the meantime, to help with the problem, you can choose to stop using products that have microbead plastics. What are microbeads? Microbeads are plastic dots in many soaps, body scrubs, and toothpaste. Any cosmetic product that has the consistency of sandpaper for exfoliation generally contains plastic. I've eliminated microbeads from my household, and even though it's not as exfoliating, the planet needs everyone's help. Something else on the topic of mollusks that I read this week and found extremely disturbing is that mussels, oysters, and other shellfish are potentially on the road to becoming poisonous to humans. Scientists have predicted that within the next 100 years, these animals will be toxic for human consumption because of rising sea temperatures and changes in salinity. The whole article is posted in the show notes. If you have questions or comments, leave them below, and I will see you next Friends with Fins Friday. Thanks for watching.